Hello, all you magnificent people. Derbo the Magnificent here, and today we're back with Pyre. In the last episode, we freed Faye. I'm pretty sure that was the last one. Yeah, alright. Well, in this one, things will happen. Ooh. Sorry there was a bit of a delay. As I said in the Terraria episode previously, I have a job now, so that kind of influenced things a bit. And I just, I don't know, I haven't been feeling up to recording recently. So, yeah, hopefully that'll change soon. And hey, Pyre's almost over, so maybe a new game will reinvigorate my want to record. But anyway, yeah, so we're gonna do this right here. And I have been told that I need to activate all of the Titan Stars for this. So, we'll see.
By now, having to make preparations for the rites has become second nature to your companions. They go about the process efficiently, and this time, in almost total silence. You cannot shake the sense that the routine shall not go on much longer. Rookie approaches, and confirms to you that the Nightwing sigil is set. Everyone has their books and raiments, and the grounds are ready. Everything should be in order.
Well, Chum, I guess it's time to pace back and forth, or whatever is your nervous tick of choice, eh? I'll, just be over here, pacing back and forth.
You and Rookie stand together in silence for a time, looking for the stars above to show some indication that the rite is to commence. It's taking too long. Concern begins to well up in you, but then here come the dissidents.
So Zeno said I would understand why I need to do all of them. Maybe the understanding comes after. I'm taking your word on this one, Zeno, and if I fail... okay, so let's see what our adversaries are gonna do. They'll have more stamina.
Endriga,
they...
The widow.
I will automatically lose 30 health. They will have a little bit of lifesteal. They'll return much sooner. The adversaries shall never be banished after plunging into my pyre. Okay, so they just don't go away after plunging into my pyre. At the start of the rite, they get 30 more health. The adversaries deal a bit more damage. Adversaries shall have much bigger auras. They'll return from banishment when all of them are banished. After they grasp the orb, their aura shall slowly shrink rather than vanish. Our adversaries shall be more cunning and much quicker to react. And our adversaries will be way faster. I'm freaking screwed.
But all of the Titan Stars?
Yeah, all of them.
Breeder, it seems the stars once more have mustered wherewithal to usher in the rites.
Indeed.
The sky grows dimmer by the day. An age is ending.
It certainly is.
Surely you must know by now that you shall never all be free.
Oh, I know.
Yet still you struggle to fulfill some senseless plan. But I digress, of course. Some of us still honor the tradition. Some of us hold dear the teachings of the scribes.
The pyres on each side are burning bright. From across the field, you observe the leader of the dissidents approach and remove his mask.
Well now, it's time we went another round then, is it, mates? Don't know how many more of these we've gotten in us these days. So, how about we make this one a real kicker, eh? Come on then, Nightwings, do your worst. I want to see you try and do some proper damage here.
Oh.
Choose quickly your triumvirate.
I'm gonna lose this one. Like, I'm gonna lose. There's no way I don't lose this. I'm gonna need Tizo.
Tizo.
And we're gonna need Rookie and Bertroot. I'm sorry, Volfred. Like, you would... Volfred would benefit the most from all this... But Volfred is trash! Like, he's okay at defense? Ah, screw it! Volfred and Rookie, let's go.
Very well.
One last time, go against these dissidents then. Let's show them what we've got. All right then, mates, you ready? You ready? Let's make these blasted stars up there wet themselves after we're through here, eh?
Oh, God. Okay, let's go.
Commence.
Wow, okay. Well, just gonna touch that guy there. Ah, shoot! That almost worked. That did not work. Thank you. Thank you. Damn it.
Your pyre is the first to fall.
I'm gonna die. Oh my lord! Lord. Okay, we did it. We did some damage. Oh no, this is not gonna work. Oh! Explode! What the fudge, dude? Oh my god! Nah, we're losing. This isn't happening. We're so dead. Alright. It's okay, I can still do this. Fudge! Oh no! It's okay. Oh my lord, this is so difficult. No! They're just so fast! Alright, just gotta defend. That worked somehow. No! Oh my god! Alright. No! They're too smart! Come on! I can do this! Pick up the ball! Get it! No! Okay, it's okay. Just gotta defend. Good. No! Nah, shoot. Okay, we just gotta defend. Defend for a bit. Good. We can do this. This is manageable. No! How the f- Oh my god, how do they do it?
A rather cunning trick.
Zeno! No! Okay. Come on. This is...
You like that, eh? Your little lick of flame back there, you better keep more than an eye on it. Shoot!
It's okay, we're fine. Tizo's coming back. Tizo's dead again. Damn it.
No!
Oh, I jumped into the wrong spot. No! Come on! No! Come on, I can do this. Oh, no! I have too much.
No. No! Shoot! It's okay. Get out of the way. Nope. No. No! Okay. Come on, I can do this. Defend for a bit. Don't let him in. Good. Drop it in! Okay. It's fine. Wolford's still alive. Defend. Wolford died. That's bad. We have to survive for a bit. Oh my god! We can do this.
Your victory is at hand.
No. We can do this. This isn't a problem. Defend. Come on! No!
Wherever did the night wind?
No! Oh, come on! No! Wait! They freaked up! They screwed up!
A show of strength from the Nightwing's opponent.
How did they do it? How did they screw up? Is it because of Wolfred? I think it's because of Wolfred. I think Wolfred had something to do with the fact that we didn't lose. Come on, I can do this. Yes!
It is done.
Holy crap!
Fine, yes, the Nightwings did prevail.
Oh, we got their 3 achievements for that.
Was extinguished there, but no.
Whew. Holy crap. If I didn't have Wolfer, we would have lost. His strong spirit saved it. Holy freaking crap, dude. That was the closest. Oh, my lord.
Tizo was pleased to have prevailed, though he wishes that the dissidents find their peace.
Oh, my god.
Well done, Nightwings. As for the dissidents, though they fought us fiercely many times, I doubt that it shall be enough. May they find mercy in this land.
Well, we showed them, didn't we? Though it's sounding like they might not get a chance to get us back. Can feel me blood still boiling after that. Would have rather snuffed that flame of yours. Hey, seeing you around these parts, come on, mates. Let's get out of here.
Well,
it
appears we have doomed the dissidents to a life of exile forever.
Until the next round, if there even is to be another one.
Holy crap.
Inside the wagon, after thwarting the dissidents, Wolfred is discussing aspects of the outcome with the others when the lone minstrel seeks you out.
Pardon the interruption, reader, though I need to ask a moment of your time, while the night is clear enough for you to see. Please, come have a look outside. Perhaps the news of your next destination may further stir the hearts of your companions.
Among what stars yet remain shining in the night, one of them now burns as bright as ever you have seen. The path to freedom calls to you again. Answer the call.
Let's go.
The cycle turns even more quickly now, until such time as it shall shudder to a halt. He makes a sound, then, almost like a laugh. I forget myself, reader. I should not say such things. The scribes, they would say that one ought focus on the path in front of him. When we set forth to walk a long and labored path, it can be all too much. If we stand back and look upon it as a whole, we may well decide to turn around. But if we begin to walk, whilst casting down our gaze, and whilst resisting the urge to look too far ahead, we may make steady, careful progress. Soon enough, we may arrive where we endeavored. The lone minstrel bids you a good evening. You had best retire for the night, for when first daylight comes, it should be time again to take to the skies.
All right, Zeno. I don't understand. Why did I do that? Why did I go through all that trouble? I mean, I got achievements out of it. Was that it? I hope that wasn't it. Because that was a lot of effort for a couple achievements. Oh, I just killed a freaking drive-in. Dang it. Yeah, well, it was wired. It was wild. Oh, what the heck?
Hey! Oh, no. Your wagon reels from the impact of some sort of massive object slamming into it mid-flight.
False Nightwings.
Orlek calls down to all of you from atop his wagon.
Again, you seek to climb that cursed mountain beneath us. Again, you seek to take my rightful place. I should send you crashing down to it, that you might fall as I have.
He stares down at you all.
But I shall not. Rather, we shall meet upon the summit, ere the last cycle of the rites is ended. Until then.
Last? Last? I only got one more chance? No. Let's go for Tizo. Let's give Tizo some help.
Oh no. You make landing on the sacred Mount Elodiel after your encounter with Orlek. Orlek spoke the truth. He has a right to gain the summit. When the time comes, Celeste shall deem him worthy and shall let him pass. While he has transgressed against the rites, he has also already been anointed and prevailed. Nothing is written in the book of this, and liberty ought already be his. For the time, it seems that he has not yet traveled to the summit. Perhaps he is still making preparations with his fellow exiles. When exactly Orlek intends to make good on his promise, he did not make clear. For now, you are to confront Barker in the distance upon the summit. But first, you may prepare.
Oh. Okay. We have another chance after that. I still don't know who I'm gonna free. God dang it.
Later that afternoon, you accompany Tizo through the old masonry of Temple High Road to the Monument of Luz Glorian. Hello again, old friend. I know that you and all the scribes are watching over me, and all of us, and I'm grateful to you. Your ancient rites are ending soon. I promise you my friends and I will make the most of our last two chances here.
Last two chances! I know who I'm freeing.
You return to the wagon after he has finished paying his respects. The summit awaits, but first, there is time to continue practicing your vocations.
Tizo gained +2 presence. Awesome! That's actually real good. I don't really know what to do. Oh, Tizo. What's up, buddy?
Tizo seems to be in the midst of conversation with the lone minstrel as you approach the two of them. The little imp appears perturbed about something. And, above all, he was very, very loyal. Fiercely so, in fact. All throughout the land knew better than to underestimate him, in spite of his little stature. In that respect, Tizo, and in many others I might add, your great-grandfather was very much like you. Tizo seems to be asking the lone minstrel to confirm he is not playing some sort of prank. I am being serious. Have you known me to be the jesting sort? Tizo seems to be admitting the lone minstrel has always been sincere with him. Just so. Then, please do not denigrate yourself, for you are not only his heir, but you are my remaining link to him, and thus, to all the eight. And, more importantly, you are my friend. Tizo is grateful to the lone minstrel for his kind words, and considers him a friend as well. The Nightwings need you now, more so than ever. Then the lone minstrel turns to you. Is that not so, reader?
Absolutely.
Tizo not only is important to the group, but seems to need a boost of confidence. You concur with the lone minstrel's assessment of Tizo as a most remarkable and irreplaceable member of the group. He is an extraordinary imp indeed. At this, Tizo rushes up to you and gives you an imp hug.
Oh! Oh! Oh, I got got a hug from Tizo! Ow! Tizo was... I'm sad. Oh, that made me so happy. Ow! Ow! God, I love Tizo so damn much.
Tizo is grateful to you for your kindness and your support of him. Tizo bounds off happily as the lone minstrel looks on. And there he goes. Thank you indeed, reader. Tizo sometimes loses sight of all that makes him special, a quality uncharacteristic of his kind, but not so much uncommon among yours. Once there was a time when he was the sole imp able to conduct the rites. Since then, however, other triumvirates have found imps with the capacity for it. They make for useful allies, no? More than willing to conduct the rites, whilst having no desire to leave this place. Although, little Tizo does have dreams of visiting the Commonwealth. In any case, I am certain he shall continue to serve the Nightwings faithfully. The lone minstrel bows his head on his way out, bidding you a good rest of the afternoon. Tizo gained plus one hope for the next rite. Wish him well.
Let's go. Oh, right. You know what? We're not really gonna have a chance to do much else with anything. So, well, I guess it's gotta be Volfrid then. Yeah, frick it.
You and Volfrid discussed the meaning of the rites, developing a deeper understanding of this contest, created to determine the worthy from among all those pitted against each other.
You're almost there, pal.
I suppose that if we had no doubts or misgivings to weigh on us from time to time, then keeping hold of faith would not be such a necessary part of all this.
Let's continue. Ah, straight to Scribe's Gate. You know what? Frick it. This one may be a bit long, but I really wanna free somebody in this episode.
A messenger imp with news and rumors from the other side somehow tracks you down in the ancient formations of Mount Elodiel. The imp's message pertains to Faye, who you liberated at the fall of Solium, and whose past transgressions have all been forgiven since her return to the Commonwealth. You learned that she was taken in by a well-to-do foster family, and was to be given private schooling of the highest order in the Astralist tradition. Astralist, a theocratic sect believing divine authority rests within the stars. They alone dictate the future. They promised her that, in time, she might one day have the honor of teaching the children of the Commonwealth herself. However, she soon went her own way, insisting that the eight scribes themselves were calling her. She started wandering again all on her own. That is, until she located Volfrid's agents. Thus, her wandering ceased, and the ranks of the revolution grew stronger. Faye also left a simple message: believe in the scribes. You thank the messenger imp for the report, as your companions gather to discuss.
That one, very powerful indeed. A sorceress of sorts. Certain air about her. Most intriguing.
You keep on telling those snooty Commonwealth good-for-nothings what's up, Faye.
She has the manner of a saint, that one. She knows in her heart the tradition of the scribes.
Tizo misses having Faye around, though is pleased to hear that she is well.
Same, buddy.
The news of Faye's liberation fills you and your fellow exiles with newfound resolve. You all gain plus one hope for the next rite. Wish Faye luck. You are returned once more to Scribesgate, where the Gate Guardian awaits under a dim sky.
The exiles of the Nightwings, and you, Tariq? This is to be one of our final meetings.
Greetings,
Celeste. The Nightwings are prepared, and afterwards I would have words with you in private, if you please.
It seems to me rather late for words now, Tariq, but I shall hear them once your charges cross the gate. Now, all of you, come forth. Please state your names and what it is that you seek whilst crossing Scribe's Gate.
Once more your companions cross the gate, one after another, and once more you follow them in turn. Celeste regards you all, then waves you through toward the summit.
The eight scribes bid the Nightwings welcome. Go forth with glory. And Tariq?
Samir.
Aye, Celeste.
You may rejoin the others in a while. For now, I would hear those words of yours.
Certainly, Celeste. Everyone, I shall see you shortly.
Good luck, buddy.
to the canyons open wide. Hear the song of change for the lost and lonesome bride.
Beautiful. What you got, buddy?
Oh, guys, it's gotten real cold again up here, but it's worth it. Let me tell you, lots of customers been stopping by. Oh, okay, may have been exaggerating just a little since I've been waiting here a little while, I guess, but you buying anything?
Possibly. You got lots of these things. I feel like I should probably buy some of those. Alright. There we go.
Thanks, guys. Good luck on the thing you're going to tonight.
Let's commence. The time has come again to deliver one of your fellow exiles to a homecoming in the Commonwealth, lest your adversary at the distance achieve the same instead. The low minstrel has returned, and approaches you as you await the signal from the stars.
There is something that I wish to ask you, reader, something which ordinarily would not be my place to discuss in any detail. You have observed the stars. If you would not mind my asking you in such a direct manner, how many liberation rites are you supposing yet remain?
Two remain, including this one.
You tell him the only logical deduction which you have been able to make based on all of your readings of the stars of late, that there shall be one final liberation rite after tonight.
I concur with your evaluation, reader, sir. I wish to make certain that you were aware, so that you and the Nightwings may yet make the most of your remaining time together, thus. As to what shall happen once the final liberation rite is ended, we shall both find out. But lo, it seems that we are called upon once more. Look forth.
Let's go. First things first, turn all of them off. I ain't doing that again. That was way too terrifying.
Reader, I would ask that you think back for just a moment, if you please. When you first looked upon the Book of Rites, think back upon the words that it revealed. Oblige the voice that tells you more. Oblige the voice that tells you more. Would that the scribes were here among us still. I would not sing your praises to them, rest assured. I trust that you shall savor this occasion. You shan't have to oblige me for much longer.
No, I won't.
The pyres burn, and each of the triumvirates is present and prepared.
I concur. The pyres burn, and each of the triumvirates is present and prepared.
Then, anointed one of the dissidents, come forth now and declare yourself, and pay any respects you have unto your adversaries, the Nightwings.
Barker bursts out from some hidden corner laughing as he paws at his mask.
A real pleasure to be here, mate. Truly. Barker Ashpaws. Call me Barker, though, all right? By the by, it was a real piss getting here, you know?
Begging your pardon, Barker Ashpaws, you thusly speak upon the summit of the Sacred Mountain.
Oh, boy, so terribly sorry to offend you there, lassie. I forgot we got the stars above up there to make me watch my language. Though, let's get one thing straight, lassie. I don't give a bother for your sacred mountain, so you take it and you shove it. Me and my pack, we're here just for the laughs, you got that? The other side ain't any better than this one. We ain't interested in your freedom.
Oh, thank God. I won't feel bad crushing you.
But, just the same, we're gonna get it. Take it from those wee little babes there so antsy for it. Hear that, you Nightwings? You better put up a good fight here, or I ain't gonna be happy, you understand?
Then he shoves his mask back on.
Right, come on then. Let's hurry up and get this damn thing started.
If you say so.
Nightwings, your choice. In whose name shall you conduct this liberation rite?
I know exactly.
I wish you the wisdom of the scribes in making your choice, reader.
And I wish you to come prepare our song with me, Tariq.
Whom shall you attempt to send home this time?
All right, Ruki. It's your time to shine, my boy.
Ruki.
Good choice there, Chum. Though if I get out of here, I don't know what you're gonna do without me.
Who shall be at his side?
It's gonna be Tizo and Vulfrid.
Tizo.
Tizo is more than willing to help Ruki get home.
And Vulfrid. Although I do want to try and give him this. I just want to see how far he can go, to be honest. Although, Vulfrid. Now is probably not the best time to experiment.
Prepare yourself, Ruki, for on this night the Nightwing shall prevail in your name and set you free.
That we shall.
All right then, mates. No more waiting. No more holding back. And let's rip him to shreds. Let's go, let's go, let's go!
Bring it. You don't have the Titan Stars on your side this time. That was a good shot.
Ooh!
Oh boy, what you gonna do about it? Whoops, that's not what I meant to do. Ah, shoot. Again, not what I meant to do. Damn it. Well, that's that.
About time we got this plastic business underway, eh, Greentail?
Ruki looks on in silence, but says nothing in response.
We can do this, we can do this, we can do this! We got it before, we can do it again. We can do it again!
It seems Ruki feels uncharacteristically confident in this outcome of the liberation night.
You never were no fun at all, Greentail, you know that, eh? You never were cut out to run with us. So if I end up getting out tonight, don't you go thinking you can have my spot, you get me? My pack would sooner cheer you up. Now, you just think on that as we go and wipe the floor with you.
Is that how it's gonna go down? Not so sure. Not so sure at all. Not sure.
What in the? All right, mate, something's gone right funny with that orb, as I can tell. Better laugh it up while we still can, eh?
Indeed, something strange seems to have happened to the celestial orb. It shudders now as though possessed of the same chaotic power as your adversaries.
What the hell? Wait, why is Ruki back?
Come on!
Damn it.
Ah, shoot!
Alright, we can defend.
Damn!
Alright, this is fine. Again, we can still defend. That's what Vulfrid's best at.
The orb is loose.
Good. Oh my god, really? No! Damn! Have to defend again. Oh, shoot.
What?
Alright, the teleportation's not helping. That's unfortunate. What are you gonna do about it, huh? What you gonna do about it? Nothing. Nothing's what? Rookie, you guys defend. Fulford's going in. Oh my god! What a legend!
Rather convincingly, I must admit.
Wow! I should have been using that ages ago. That was insane!
The liberation right. And thus, the scribes have chosen. The exile appointed by the Nightwings shall be free. Absolved of all misdeeds. Return to glory in the Commonwealth. His adversary and all others shall remain to carry out their rightful sentences.
What a joke. Here I was, thinking we were gonna make him cry after all this. Come on, mates. I'm right handy with this stuck-up place. So let's get out of here already, eh?
Don't really feel bad for them. I'm glad it was them that we faced.
So, do what now? I guess I'm just supposed to jump into this waterfall thing back here, and that's it. Home free. Home free.
Something comes over him then.
Now, listen to me, Chunks. Don't any of you go thinking you're gonna miss me, eh? You're gonna do just fine, even without old Rookie Green there. There to keep an eye out for you all the time. Even though the rest of you are just a bunch of slowpokes and all that. Me, I'm gonna be so busy drinking myself silly on Commonwealth stock, I'm sure I'm soon gonna forget each and every one of you. But, just in case I don't, you'll be sure to stop by and visit me if you ever get back there too. Just look for old Mama Greentail's shop, right in the heart of town. You can't miss it. So, yeah, stop by, say hi, you know. Now, I think I gotta go, so, excuse me.
He drops into the shimmer pool and disappears within, although you can still hear him going on about something.
Oh, let me tell you, this is weird in here. Hey, Starkey. Wait.
Rookie earned back his freedom. May he return in glory.
Godspeed, Rookie Greentail.
See ya, buddy.
The cycle of the rites is nearly at an end.
Gotta get you back to Mama.
It is possible our plan shall not succeed, despite our fiercest efforts here and in the Commonwealth, but I know for certain that our efforts shall not be in vain. We learn and strive together. We prevail or we fail together. On this path we share, it has been and shall continue to be my greatest honor.
Alright, just as a defensive measure, it works fine. So I'm gonna go with Miracle Kindling, just to save me.
You return to the wagon after having prevailed against the dissidents in the Liberation Rite. Tizo wishes Rookie a safe journey home.
Safe travels to you, Rookie. The rest of us await the day of our reunion on the other side.
You succeeded in liberating Rookie, who returned to the Commonwealth in glory.
The last of the stars still shine for us above. At this point, what is to become of our plan needn't be the subject of our speculation. I trust that we'll learn the outcome soon enough. Our actions to this point shall pave the way, perhaps our faith as well. So let's for now focus on this. We stand upon the brink of the last turn of the cycle of the rites. Soon, we'll have a final chance to get one of you home. Now, reader, up for a little stargazing? Let us see where in the downside we shall be returning for these final rites.
You turn back toward the darkness, to look upon the last few stars too stubborn to relinquish their light. The scribe stars yet burn for you atop the sacred mountain, determine where they lead.
What a shame. Let's go against the Pyre Hearts one last time.
Once more, you are to face the Pyre Hearts. Then, although I wonder... He hesitates before saying anything further. You cannot sense his thoughts. I apologize. I was lost in thought there for a moment. Let us make way for the Khan of Haroub, when everyone is feeling more refreshed as much as possible.
Let's talk first.
Following Ruki's liberation, the lone minstrel has returned to the wagon and stands as though nothing has happened here this night. He tilts his head a bit as you approach.
Once more, the Nightwings have prevailed in the liberation rite under your mindfulness, reader. A commendable achievement. Surely Ruki shall live out his days in gratitude to you and your companions. Perhaps he may now seek Sir Gilman there in your commonwealth. I should think Sir Gilman would have liked to witness what took place this night. I trust that, together, they shall make a formidable difference to the plan which all of you endeavor to achieve. Now, for the time, Celeste and I are to return to our respective stations. We all await the next turn of the cycle of the rites. May you prevail once more when next we traverse Scribesgate. Until then, reader, rest well under the stars. He nods and leaves you to recover after a long night.
Thanks, man. Alright, well, I'm gonna end this episode here. I'm pretty sure the next episode's gonna be the finale. We're almost out. Who are we gonna free next? I know. You all probably know as well, but... I don't know. I'll, just in case you don't know, I'm not gonna say anything until it's time. Anyway, that is going to do it for the potentially penultimate episode of Pyre. Thank you all so much for watching. Hope y'all have a magnificent day. Derpo the Magnificent out.